Welcome children in the science class. Today we will learn chapter 5 birds beaks and claws. Children, in the previous class, that is in class 3, you have already learned about birds beaks and feathers and some nesting habits of the birds. And in this class we will learn about the feeding habits of the birds. So let's start. Birds, like other living beings, need food, but they do not have teeth to eat their food. So, birds do not have teeth to eat their food. They use their beaks and claws to catch and eat food. They also use them to protect themselves from their enemies. So, birds do not have teeth. They have beaks and claws that help them to catch and eat food. And it also helps them to protect themselves from their enemies. Okay, now next is, there is an activity. Let's see what it is given. Visit your neighborhood areas and observe different birds on trees, in water, on the ground and in the bushes. Now identify some common birds and observe the kind of food they eat. On the basis of your observation, complete the following table. Now children, you have to observe the different kinds of birds that you see in your neighborhood areas, and you have to identify and write their names, and you have to also write the place where you saw it and what are the types of food they eat, whether they eat grains, leaves, grass, wheat, flesh, etc. Okay, so let's move ahead. Like other animals, some birds eat flesh, that is, some birds eat meat, some eat seeds, and some eats fruit, roti, etc. The type of a bird's beaks and claws is related to the type of food it eats. Now let's come to the beaks. Birds do not have teeth. They use their beaks to tear, bite, chisel or crush. Chisel means to crush or to break down into small pieces of the food. The shape of the beak is according to the food habits of the bird. Some birds use their beaks to fight the enemy or catch their prey. They also use it for preening their features. Now let's see what is preening. It is given in do you know, preening means to clean the feathers and set them right. Okay, the birds spread the wax secreted at the base of the feathers during this process. Now let's see different types of beaks. First is crushing beaks. You can see here the pictures of a sparrow, pigeon and parrot. Birds like sparrow and pigeon have a short and hard beak. So sparrow and pigeon have short and hard beak. They use it for crushing seeds and grains, which these hard beak helps them to crush the grains and seeds, thereby make them soft before eating. Now next is curved beak. Okay, birds like parrot have a curved beak. Here you can see the pictures of a parrot beak that is bent little bit and it is red in color. This helps them in cracking nuts and fruits. The curved beaks of the parrot helps it to cracking nuts and fruits. Now next is piercing and tearing beak. Some birds like eagle and vulture eat flesh. Such birds have a strong, hard and curved beak that help them to tear the flesh. Here you can see the picture of an eagle and vulture. They have strong, hard and curved beak that help them to tear the flesh. So eagle and vulture are flesh eating birds. Now it is given in do you know. There are some birds which can imitate our voice. Parrot is one of them. It means that it can speak like us. Crows and hens have beaks that help them to eat a variety of foods like meat, fruit, grains and insects. Now, next is chiseling beak. Birds like the woodpecker have a strong, long and straight beak. So, you can see the picture of a woodpecker that this type of bird have strong, long and straight beak. This helps them to peek at the wood and eat insects present in the wood. So, this woodpecker, it eats insects that are present in the wood. It is given in Do You Know? While peeking at something, a bird moves its head forward quickly and bites at it. Next is probing beak. Some birds like the hummingbird. You have studied in class 3 that hummingbird is the smallest bird in the world. The sunbird and the hoof have a long and slender beak. Now, hummingbird, sunbird and hoof, this type of bird have long and slender beak. Sunbirds sucks nectar from flowers while hoof takes out insects and worms from the holes in the ground. Here you can see the long beak of hummingbird and hoof. Now, shifting beak. The duck has a flat and broad beak which has small holes on both sides. Here you can see the beak of a bird with hole. It digs up the food along with mud from the base of the pond or lake. Its beak pushes out the mud and water from the holes, leaving the food behind. Its beak thus helps it to shift food from mud and water. That means the beak of the duck helps the duck to shift food. That means to separate food from mud and water. Now, next is sticky beak. A swallow has a small, broad and sticky beak. Swallow is a small bird which has broad and sticky beak. The beak is sticky from inside. This helps the swallow to catch flies while flying. The name of this bird is swallow, as it catches its prey while flying and its beak are sticky from inside. Okay, it is given in Do You Know? The arrival of flocks of swallow is a sure sign that summer is on its way. The arrival of flocks means whenever the swallows are seen in groups, that means that summer season is on its way or summer season is near. Okay, children, that's all for today. And your activity is you have to do page number 32 and do it in your science copy. And those who don't have the do it in your science book. And those who don't have the science book, do it in your science copy. That's all for today. Thank you.